How's it going, everyone? My name's Kev Knight, and I'm a car salesman from...
Hold on, are we allowed to be called car salesmen anymore?
Well, I'm not a car saleswoman, am I?
I don't think you can call it that either.
Maybe you're like a car salesman.
You know what? I don't even like calling myself a car salesman. Everyone just assumes you're a crook straight away.
Well, rightly so for some of them.
But, well, mate, don't call yourself it at all. Start again.
Hello everyone, my name's Kev Knight and I sell cars for a living. Well, I try to sell cars for a living, and I started this channel to show everyone what it's like for a car dealer, sort of like a day in the life of a car dealer, to see what we go through day in, day out. No one really knows it, sort of. Everyone thinks they know it. So I started this channel so everyone could see what it's like as a bit of an insight. And I tell you what, this is the third part of this little car's journey. And we'll quickly revert back to see how this little car became here. Let's quickly go back.
It's here, because I don't want any shit. You can see me walking past all these cars. I don't really do French cars. I definitely don't do Vauxhall Insignias. And I definitely don't do Vauxhall Corsas. Blimey, there's a Vauxhall Corsa. Honda Jazz, they're good little cars, they are. 92,000 miles on a mini petrol 7 owners. Is that a good looking little car? I mean, it's red, which has got a sunroof. It's red, that definitely goes against it. It's got Mannheim plates, so I reckon that probably had a private plate on it. Grade 5, 2 owners. No history, front headlight bulb, LED not illuminating. 111, one key, that's a shame. 111 isn't the end of the world if this thing's got history. Yeah, all right, it could have a rattly timing chain at 111, but it also could not start rattling until 180,000 miles.
2209, there is the 118, diesel school, there's one, we've been away, 23 now, 21, with a shell check. Oh, look at that, it's got a roof as well, we've been away, what have we seen this one? 7 it goes, 8, 8 it goes there, but 800, 800, 800, 800, 800, 800, 800, 9, 9 is there, you in? 15,000, 1,000 it goes, 15,000, 15 goes there, but 1,000, 15, 11, 8, 11, 11, 15, 11, 15, 11, 15, 12, 12.
I can't do it. I can't do it. When I was editing this bit, I can't watch that auction again. Can't watch that auction again. If you want to see that auction, I'll put part 2 of this little car in the description below. But for those of you that didn't see it, we should have ducked out at about £1,300. For those of us that know what we're doing at auction, I should have stopped at about £1,300. I didn't.
25, 2, 25, 15. You in? 2215, once, twice, 2215.
Should have a set. Yep, paid way too much for the car. Way too much for the car. And then just after we bought the car, this happened. Oh. What is going on? I literally just bought that little 1 Series. You've seen me drive it home. I mean, that is not happy, is it? That was good as gold on the way home, and now the suspension's collapsed. It hasn't even moved. Oh, good Lord. And then after we had that fixed, this noise started, and this happened.
The chains go slack, the lack of oil pressure and things like that make them rattle. So, yeah, I think you've just been a bit unlucky, mate.
I have been unlucky. So then we got it booked in for a timing chain, and we're going to catch up with it just before it went in. Well, here she is, alongside my Ignis, which I really should get on with. So it's been a few weeks since I made that last video. Oh, got my legs stuck. Let's fire her up. See it, don't you? It doesn't even get the normal cold rattle that you get from these cars when they've got noisy timing. I mean, am I being too stupidly fussy with this car? Oh, I just don't know. Oh, I can still hear that noise.
Oh, I don't know. I've got to be honest. Sort of hoping that is
going to be all right, because I mean, that is pretty... That is, look at that, that is holding on by a thread. I hope that's going to be all right. Oh, let's get it. We're back in the little one series. So hopefully this is going to be a nice, pleasant little journey for the first part of getting this little car back to full health. We'll see you at Hemmingstone BMW in a minute. Well, we're here. It's clear. Bless it. Next time we see this, hopefully, she won't have that noise. I've just come in. Toby's servicing the John Cooper Works, which has only done 16,000 miles. But for the next little instalment, just so happens that the little one series diesel is up on the ramp with a rather large hole where the engine should be, just in case anyone says that we didn't do the chains. There's the new flexi on the exhaust. Here's Elijah on me, taking me engine apart.
Hello.
Let's have a little look in. Look at that, look, it's nice and clear. The cams are small, isn't they? Feels like it's really small.
The hole, yeah?
For a two lit, what the cams are?
They are on the older ones. I'm not sure
about
this one. Yeah, the hole.
There's me. Oh, look, the flexi's not looking the best, is it? No wonder that was a bit wobbly.
Yeah.
So we can tell quite happily that it's obviously been quite well looked after, because how clean it is in here. I'm furious that someone stole the service book to this car.
It's not ideal, is it?
It's not ideal. It's going to be a cool little car once it's done.
Sunroof,
it has got a sunroof, really, and black leather.
That's really rare, that type of thing.
Might possibly be the biggest financial loss I've ever had. So all we can do is laugh.
You win something recently?
Yes. Oh, the excitement! Oh, mate, it's well clean in there.
Yeah, it's mint.
Do you know what? Are we doing these when they don't really need to be done? Because
this one's out a little bit further than it should be.
Good. That's good.
Because the timing's meant to be there.
Right.
These are meant to be accessible.
Right.
As you can see, they're not.
Oh, so it is a little bit worn. Oh, yes, that's good.
They aren't the worst I've seen, but they are.
That's good. Hold on, I'm getting a phone call. Right, I've got to quickly sign off because they want to go home. Clutch is perfect. Engine's well clean. He wants to go home. Right, I'm getting me a Mini. I'm going home. Sorry. See you later. Oh, it's exciting times, people. Just had a phone call from Mark from Hemmingstone Garage saying the little red one series is done. Let's go pick it up.
Hey,
well, here she is. Hemmingstone Garage. Bless her. Oh, she could definitely do with a clean. Let's get her home. Oh, it sounds better already. Oh, it sounds better already. I can hear that it doesn't do it already. You know what, we'll quickly sneak down here. God, it does drive well, this little car.
How you going?
We're back in the... I think so, this is probably officially the longest I've ever had a car in stock. But we are back. Chains are done. You know what, I didn't want to pay to get this done. But the fact is, I'm glad I have got it done. It's silent now. This is what it should sound like in the first place, if BMW didn't let me down with their worn out chain guides. But we're back in. We can actually get back onto this little car and maybe, just maybe, get it up for sale. See you in a bit.
Well, there she is, look. She's back. Very, very, very much just in. That's a little bit of a fib. Need to put just in about 8 months ago. A weight in preparation. Well, I need to put a very much a weight in preparation, really, because I mean, it's a bit, I'm not sure the grip. I might have to take this home. It's a little bit embarrassing to have on the forecourt, isn't it? Look at the, oh dear. Maybe we'll take this home until I can get onto it. To be continued.
Well, I thought I'd better get this bit on film because It is 10 to 5 on Friday night. I'm having a bit of a move around because the little red one series, I think it started life there, then it went there, and it's slowly going around, getting ready to go in the workshop and for me to start prepping. Good greenness going on. It's been sitting around for so long, bless it. For how long it's been sitting around, it actually looks pretty good, doesn't it, really? If you think about it, you can see how long it's been sitting around. It hasn't started growing plants yet, like that Nissan Patrol that I bought. Unfortunately, this is my fault that it looks like this. The Nissan Patrol sort of wasn't, because obviously that had been sitting around. So let's get this thing washed, which won't be today, because I've got to do something else, so it won't be today, but I am now moving this, so I thought we'd quickly film it, and then next time you see this, it'll be getting washed. So the last time, when I moved the one series from, it was out here, wasn't it? So it was over there where that countryman is, we just had a little bit of a move around and got it in there. Well, that was about 10 days ago. I think it's been sitting here about 10 days at the back there, because we bought other cars as we sort of like to, and they end up sitting around here, and then we had the flood and other stuff's been going on. You saw this on the flood video. Well, obviously it's real poorly, but it is 10 to 5 now. We're going to do the initial wash on the one series. I mean, I'm not going to film the whole thing. I'm not going to film the whole process of prepping this car, because in reality, it's sort of going to be a more heavy duty version of the F10 that we've just done the video on. So we'll do some little snippets. I don't know what this car is going to come up like. I mean, it might end up being 15 different colours. I don't know. We'll see. But it's so far now that I haven't got any other choice but to retail it, and, you know, it's all fixed now. Well, I think, you know, mechanically. let's get out. Let's give it a wash. It's like under here. Good Lord. Well, I think we need to get on the case. I feel like this is actually going to end up cleaning up quite well. Be quite a good one. Let's get on it. Well, there she is. I mean, look at that. So I purposely haven't dried it, so you can sort of see what it's going to be like, hopefully, when I finish mopping it and prepping it and everything, because that's a great thing about when you wash a car. You can sort of see what it's going to look like, because the tyres are still wet, so they look shiny. The body's still wet, so it looks shiny. And you know what? Most of my cars, when I wash them, they end up looking like this when they're dry. Unfortunately, this one doesn't, because as soon as it dries, it doesn't shine anymore. I mean, you can see it. Yeah, right, it looks shiny on. It looks shiny on the camera. That's the most scary thing about a camera, really. Anything looks good on pictures, but you know, there's no denying that. You get customers all the time, oh, I've seen one on Auto Trader, it looks amazing in the pictures, and you just think, oh good Lord, such a worry when you hear that. But you know, at least it's clean now, there's no more green bits on it anymore. It's just taken me 3/4 of an hour to do that. Done some serious decontamination on the wheels. I mean, they were pretty bad. They'll end up looking all right when they're done, when I've cleaned them up. It's gonna look all right though. Let's get it back in the workshop and let's get it dry, get it back in the workshop. Now here it is dry. Do you know what? It looks so much better looking through my camera on here to what it actually looks like in real life. You can't really see how dull it is. It is dull, but I suppose the only positive getting out of that is me, that's going to look real good when I've finished with it. I don't understand how it looks so good on the camera. It looks horrendous in real life. I think it does. Oh, let me put my light on. Oh, can you see how bad that is? And patches are so patchy. Oh, you can see it, can't you? Hideous. I hope I can make this look as good as I think I'm going to make it look. But for now, I'm going home. Sorry I don't reply to everyone's comments. I try to. It's cool when you comment. But I want to say, Tom, if I didn't reply to your comment yet, hopefully I did, but if I didn't, my mum read your comment and she said, can you tell Tom that me and Dad are fine and thanks for asking? See you tomorrow. Well, here we are. It's the next morning. It still looks shiny, doesn't it? Did I just put it up for sale like that? So I'll tell you what we're going to do. There's no way that I'm going to film the whole journey of doing this prep because I'm under major risk of spending too long on this car, which I really don't want to do, but it's in such a bad shape, look how bad shape it's in. So I think I'm just going to crack on, and I mean, this it needs touching up. I don't know what colour it is yet. I have to phone BMW up, see if we can get a touch-up for it. It's probably discontinued now. If it is, then I'll get one made up because, I mean, it's clearly I haven't got money in this car to be repainting everything, so it's all just going to get touched up. Even the little marks on the wheels will get touched in, although they're really not that bad. New centre caps, obviously, do the interior. We'll do a couple of little snippets. I mean, I really just want to mop like a patch in the middle of the bonnet to see what it's going to come up like. I'll tell you, let's quickly do that. You can see that bit I haven't done. You can see the reflection of that light compared to that light. It's pretty sharp there. I've just done that patch there. Let's have a look under here. Wow, look at that. That's mad. See, I can't work out whether that's good or bad, because that means I can make it look like that fairly easily. Oh, Christ, it looks like a different colour. But how long is it going to take to... Oh, I've got to do it. Right. Right, people. I'm going around the whole car. I've got to show you this bit of this bonnet look. So this bonnet's obviously been repainted, which I'm pretty sure I remember saying when we bought the car from auction a couple of years ago or whenever it was. Everything's been painted on it, but it's old. And but like you can see where they've flattered this bonnet. Look how hideous that is in that reflection. So I've done this bit here. You can see how much. I mean, you can almost get it fully corrected, which I'm trying not to do. I'm trying not to do that. I know I'm not a detailer, but when a car's been painted and you don't keep on top of it, that is how flat it ends up. Look how bad that is. And I can make it look like that. So it's like, oh dear. So it could be shiny, this car. I'm not filming it. It's going to take forever. So we'll do a little... Hold on. Never tried this before. Well, people, here we go. What do you think? Because for now, this car is done. I mean, what have we done here? We've done some... I mean, I haven't edited this video as of yet, so I can't exactly remember how I'm going to go about putting it out. We've done some serious mopping on the paint. We've heavy compounded the whole car, which luckily, because it's clear coated, so it isn't a metallic, this car, so it hadn't faded, but the clear coat on top of it was obviously heavily scratched, so it made it look sort of dull, shall we say. So what we've ended up doing, we've ended up bringing the clear coat back and taking as many scratches out as we possibly could. It hasn't faded, but it does look, I mean, it's a well-presented little car now, isn't it? We'll get it outside in a minute and we'll have a look. So we've done the wheels, we've put new centre caps in the wheels, obviously we've done the tyres, new number plates front and rear. You can't see that one. I'll put a little bit of clip on now so you can see it going on. Can't see that one because I've put our branded cover on it. You can see the cheeky little new one on the back there. I'll put a little clip on that of that going on as well. Inside is now actually quite a nice little place to be. You know, we've done a lot of work on the inside. We've scrubbed all the seats. I'll put some little infill snippets on here so you can see we've scrubbed the seats with the all-purpose cleaner, scrubbed the steering wheel, all of the dash and everything, because it had like that funny white, almost sun cream look on it, didn't it? I don't know what all this looks like. Someone's had like Suda cream all over the door panels, or suntan cream or something. I don't know. I'll get all of that off with my all-purpose cleaner. So we've done everything with the all-purpose cleaner, front and rear. Obviously, we've hoovered out the carpets. We'd already jet washed the mats, front and rear. So I'll just show you. Someone going past on his bike. I'll show you a little clip here, just putting the mats in. I mean, they're already nice and clean, as you can see. But then after we'd done the all-purpose cleaner on the seats, we then blacked everything with our dressing. So everything black is now black, or everything black is now blacker. And then finished it off with cleaning the glass. Cleaned the glass inside and out. I mean, what else did we do here? Am I forgetting anything? Done underneath the bonnet. I think I've got a little clip of me doing underneath the bonnet. We'll show you underneath the bonnet anyway. There you go, look. Looks very presentable under there, doesn't it? It's actually not quite a cool little car. What I'll do, we'll move that Volvo. We'll get it outside, see what she looks like outside. Well, there she is, people. She's all done. The sun's out. There's the sun up here. Beautiful day. And the little one series is done. Now, when I say it's done, I mean, it isn't completely done. And that's because I've had it so long now that that the MOT has expired on it. But you know what? I really want to get this video out. So we're going to make the world's worst assumption and assume that it's going to go through its MOT all right. It might not. And if it doesn't, then we'll milk this little car a bit more and we'll make a part four. But for now, I haven't gone through costings yet, I'll be honest with you. I don't even know what I'm going to put the car up for sale for. I'm going to work out what it owes us and then we will put it up for sale. I mean, the market's a funny place now. It's almost good that I've spent 13 years waiting to get this car prepared, because I mean, the cheaper market has gone up at the moment. The cheaper market has actually gone up in price and the slightly lumpier stuff is dropping. So we might be able to ask a bit more for it. I don't know. I know this isn't a perfect ending to this one. We might have to make a little bit of an extension on a part four, because there is still a few things to do with this car. I just want to get this video out now. You know, I know it takes ages getting videos out. I know it's been too long. I want to get this video out for this one. So we'll get this video out. If there's anything else that I need to tell you along the way, then I will do. I mean, that's a pretty looking little car, isn't it? It drives really nice. It's now a nice place to be inside. Let's get it up for sale. After we've MOT'd it, obviously. But for now, I say thanks for watching this, everyone. Hit that subscribe button if you like what's going on. Hit that like button. Send us a little comment if you like what's going on. Send us a little comment if there's another video that you would like us to do. Me and Claire are going to do an auction challenge probably next week. Go to auction with probably $4,000 or $5,000 each, maybe. See what we can buy, turn it around, see who can make the most money. You guys asked for that a few videos back, so there's a possibility that that might happen. But thanks for watching this video, everyone. Have a good weekend. I'll see you on the next one. Thanks a lot. Bye, 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 bye. How can I make this look even worse for the thumbnail? Make it look like it's been here even longer. Hold on. Put a bit of old, put a bit of old insulation on there like that. Put a bit of old insulation. See, people like, oh, I don't want to scratch it. what else can we put there? Make it look like it's been here a bit longer, that old tire. We'll put that there. What about an old Hoover? everyone leans stuff up against stuff that's hanging around, don't they? You put the old hoover there. What about a ladder? Oh, a ladder. That's a good idea. What about that? There you go. Look, don't scratch it, Kev. There you go. What does that look like? Yeah, bless it.